the top 10 pendulum decks of August 2020, aka the top 10 Yu-Gi-Oh decks of 2020. Let's go! If you're in the video, smash the subscribe button. Smash the subscribe button. This is gonna be a good one. Stay tuned to the end of the video to figure out. You can have some of your favorite decks in this list. I thought long and hard about this list. And if you guys want to support pendulums, and if you want to support Konami of bringing Electromite out of the ban list, check out tripgaming.com and get a beautiful Toon Electromite cloth playmat. Because a purchase of every Toon Electromite cloth playmat goes towards the cause of fighting Konami to bring back Electromite in some weird way, shape, or form. Because every dollar that gets donated to my account is like more videos for me. So that's like more fighting Konami. Anyways, okay, let's get it, boys. Top 10 pendulum decks of August 2020. Let's get it. Top 10 pendulum deck time. Let's go. Honorable mentions. We're doing some honorable mentions. This card just missed the top 10 list. Magic Spectres missed the list. Let me tell you, Magic Spectres are pretty good right now. I would like to see an invoked Needle Fiber deck, Synchro El Dragma bullshit deck, deal with one interruption. One Veiler stops the deck, let alone a Tornado, or Magic Spectre Tornado, or Magic Spectre Tempest. Get out of my face. Magic Spectre is better than all those decks. Cleaver Turbo. Cleaver Turbo. You guys want to see Cleaver Turbo? That's some honorable mention. Pure Odd Eyes. Not like Magician Odd Eyes with Revolution Dragon. I'm talking about pure Odd Eyes, like all Odd Eyes cards. I put that honorable mention. Chaos Pendulums, a list I have not shown you guys yet. Dynamis Endymion is also really good. Not really good, but it made the honorable mention of the top 10 pendulum decks. Those five decks, if you guys want to see any of them, let me know down below in the comments. And if you guys like any of the top five decks a lot, I don't mind showcasing a video of them. I have like a solid build for each of the five. I can show you guys in the future of any of those decks if you guys like it. And let's start, boys. Number 10 is pure Zephra Control. It's not Zephra Endymion. This is pure Zephra Control. I've never been a fan of trap decks. I think they absolutely suck. They're not control. I'm a more control player, man. Shut the hell up, all right? You're just playing a bad deck. That's what you're doing. You just don't know how to combo, so you're not playing combo decks. Pure Zephra Control is number 10 at best. Number 9 is DDD. Now, this is a combo deck. This is... DDD is a good deck, man. DDD is a very good deck. DDDs, I like my decks, I like my woman. DDDs, you already know, let's go. So this is a good deck, you know, put up solid boards, put up unbreakable boards, to be honest. And it could arguably be a little higher on this list, but it's not better than Metal Foes. That's number 8. Metal Foes is, look out, bro. Look out for Metal Foes. Look out for Metal Foes. Metal Foes is legit. I'm sure you guys have seen my Metal Foes list by now, but Metal Foes is legit. Metal Foes, you can take this to any rogue competition. I built my Metal Foes deck, so there's no like cards that are banned from rogue competition in it. You just play Metal Foes and you destroy your opponent. I mean, it's really, 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 really good. And then we got number 7, we got Dracopal. I'm talking about the dragon version. You guys have seen my Dracopal version, my Pepe version. My Dracopal version is based really on LP and triggering the dragons and let them bring out Sloth. And then because you have Revolution Dragon and you're drawing into a lot, you could draw into another Revolution Dragon, another Sky Iris, because Geek Turtle and Wizard. You could get Lekkery and you'll have Sloth Lekkery, which is a cool lock for your opponent. Number 6, how about Pepe Revolution? This is pure Pepe, not with Guard Dragons, pure Pepe with Revolution Dragon searching either Luster Pendulum or Darkworm for Penkal Darkworm. You got Pepe Revolution Magician, so like Pepe Magician Revolution, like rank 4 spam. I put that number 6. I think it's a really good deck, actually. I'm a big fan of that list. A really big fan. And hint, hint. There might be a Pepe playmat. We're getting released soon. Just saying. Pepe Revolution playmat, maybe. Just saying. That's how much I view this deck. I think it's very, very good. Number 5, I'm putting Ignite Infernoble. Ignite Infernoble is 100% a Pendulum deck. Half the deck is Pendulum cards. So it's very cool how it works. Very, very cool how it works. You could potentially put a Servant or Abductor in it. Potentially, I would probably not recommend that because Ignites like to have the scales for themselves. But there's a lot of spell cards you play in that deck, so Ignite Infernoble is actually pretty damn good. So I'm gonna put that number 5. Number 4, I'll be putting Zephra Endymion. So Zephra Endymion is a deck that in the past I've been tripping a lot, saying it's not that good, and honestly, it's not that good. It's not. But just the only reason I'm not a fan of Zephra Endymion is that you could draw too many like Zephra cards. And you're just playing a bunch of bricks at that point. So that's why I'm not a big fan of it. But the fact that Zephra Endymion has the opportunity to take it easy. It doesn't need to go like all out. You could like save scales for next turn. You could play slower depending on the matchup. But you still are resolving Servant and Abductor every single turn. I'm a fan of that. That's what I'm a fan of. The fact that you're resolving so many, you get so many extra spell cards in this deck because of all the Zephyr spells. So it's cool to add in together. I'm a fan of it. Number three is another Endymion version, and that is Mythical Endymion. Mythical Endymion is definitely not in the top two, but it's better than Zephyr Endymion, the card that is named under down below. Mythical Endymion offers a garbage board, but it offers lots of potential for bricks, but you kind of know what you're getting. It's good in the long run of a duel. We're talking like, let's say there's a format where duels can get to turn 5, turn 6, then Mythical Endymion is very powerful in turn 5, because by then you shouldn't be having your institution, as long as you don't get rid of your institutions, all your mythical cards are being holding lots of counters. Counters that Mighty Master could potentially draw into to destroy your opponent with. So it's good in the grind game, turn 4, turn 5. Is it good turn 1? No. Does it brick? Yes. Does it lose the hand traps? Yes. But at the same time, it's not a turn 1 deck. Mythical Endymion, I recommend for people that like to play in turn 5. I personally like winning in turn 0. So I'm not a fan of Mythical Endymion, but if you like playing in turn 5, play Mythical Endymion because you're not winning turn 1. Number 2 is Magician Revolution. So this is Magician Endymion Revolution, where you're playing a full Endymion list. You cut off unneeded cards in Endymion, like the second Jackal or the third Mighty Master, even a Reflection. Cut anything that's not absolutely required, maybe even cut Chronograph. You put in a small Magician Engine to resolve Pen Call. You play 6 Pen Call. And you play a Revolution Engine to search Dark Worm. And the whole idea is you add in Pen Call, Dark Worm, and the already best deck pure Endymion. The issue I found with this deck is it loses to Nibiru a little bit more. But this format, no one's playing Nibiru. So Magician Revolution can arguably be the best call this format with literally nobody playing Nibiru right now, because Nibiru is bad against the top decks. So since Nibiru is bad against the top decks, a lot of people are just not playing it. Number one is Pure Endymion. This should not come as a surprise. Pure Endymion is absolutely incredible. Pure Endymion can do some crazy things. Every single turn, it's not just the most consistent list, because it's playing 20 draw cards, so it is the most consistent list, but it's not just the most consistent list. It also puts up the biggest board. It still puts up 7 negates, Pure Endymion. We're talking Endymion Restage, like my version of Turbo Endymion, is the most consistent, the best going second, the best first hand traps, the best board, the best everything. And a lot of people would say something with Pendulum, that, well, Pendulum don't have a lot of follow-up. But what they don't understand about Endymion cards is you specifically set up your board to be the most consistent. So if your board's the most consistent and most the best versus hand traps, you're setting up like a double Mighty Master and a Reflection with Vortex Jackal every game with the right hand. But that Mighty Master is bouncing a card back. That Reflection is bouncing a card back. That Mighty Master is bouncing a card back. The Abductor is going to add a card for your next turn. So it's like, even if you have 0 cards in your hand, you actually, to start your turn, you have like 4 cards, because all your cards bounce, if that makes sense. So Pure Endymion also even has the best follow-up in my eyes, because it's the most consistently puts up your board. And if you most consistently put up your board, your Mighty Master and Reflection are resolving, which put cards back into your hand. So even though it shows like 2 cards in your hand or 0, it's more like 5 by the end of it. But that's the top 10 Pendulum decks in August 2020. Top 10 Yu-Gi-Oh decks 2020. Oops. There are a few other cards. There is one deck that I'm testing right now that I had not put in the honorable mention. This is kind of like a little secret for those that, a little surprise slash gift. This is a gift for everyone that has watched to the very end of this video. And that is Endymion Invoked Dragma. I'm working on a very good list right now where it just turbos out. You throw in Spell Power Mastery and Servant of Endymion as an engine, and you play one Jackal and Mighty Master. This allows you to play triple Magician Souls, and you just get so much more value out of the deck. You get so much more value out of the Alistair, because it lets you make Cross Sheep to actually get a free Selene and a free Appaloosa. And because you're playing a bunch more spell cards, your Selene, Appaloosa, Cross Sheep combo is always resolving. So instead of ending, like, let's say Invoke Dragma, I don't think it's a really good deck. Ends on like Mikaba, Dragma, Ecclesia, and like Punishment, maybe a Hand Trap. Well, the Magician, the Endymion version would end on the same thing, except plus an Appaloosa, plus a Mighty Master with Servant. So, and what the deck's missing is a spell negate. So I think it's very, very powerful. I'll show you guys after I'm done the list. I'm still tweaking the list a bit, so you guys can get like the best version. Because you're playing Souls, you play Allure, Upstart, you play so many more draw cards. And with all these draw cards, you're still playing a triple Droplet, like triple Imperm. Cards that are still good going second, triple Tactical Talents. So it's like you're still playing a normal Invoke Dragma list, but with the best part of Pendulum, which is a servant engine. And I'm gonna try and play Abductor in it too, but I wouldn't play Abductor unless you're playing Kepler and take out the invoke cards, and Kepler go for Needle Barber combo. But I think Alistair is very good in this deck. So that's the top 10 videos for you guys, top 10 Pendulum decks for you guys. I think it's amazing. If you guys want to see the honorable mention decks, let me know. If you guys want to see a Zephyr deck, let me know as well. I haven't done that in a while. And if you guys like the video, don't forget to get a Bebo Trip Game playmat, the 2 Millennium Cloud playmat before it sells out. If you guys want 2-player mats, message me on Facebook. There's none on the site no more. And if you guys like want to learn more about Pendulum, sign up on Pendulum Training down below. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.